Experienced lifters absolutely dread January when the New Year's resolutioners flood into the gyms. In this video, I'm going to give you experienced workout folk a strategy that will help you cope with the crowds and actually have some pretty amazing workouts. But before we get into that, I want to talk to you New Year's resolutioners who are just joining a gym at the first time. If you want to be part of the 95% who only go in January after buying a whole year's gym membership and then burn out and never go to the gym again, then just keep doing what you're doing. If you want to be in the 5% of New Year's resolutioners who actually go to the gym consistently all year round, let me give you three pointers. One, you need to have realistic expectations. Please go to my muscle gain calculator and get an idea what is realistic. Second of all, use a good nutritional plan instead of a stupid fat diet. CustomMealPlanner.com will give you amazing free meal plans that are optimal for fat loss and muscle gain, rather than those stupid fad diets that leave you hungry all the time until you end up binging and eating pizza after pizza. The third suggestion for you New Year's resolutioners is to take it slow. You got out of shape after decades of neglect. You're not going to turn around in 1 month, so take it really slow. The most important thing is that you don't get injured. So don't start off by running 10K a day. You're going to kill yourself and it doesn't do any good. Start off by walking. Start with a beginner workout program like I have on my website, Scooby's Workshop. I have beginning home workouts for gym and also for home. So now let me give you workout strategies for you intermediate and advanced lifters. Some of you are strength trainers. You're doing a 5x5 or a periodization type workout program. That's great. But January is a great chance to do something different and give your joints a chance to recuperate. And not only that, to keep your sanity in trying to do your normal workout routine in a gym that's a boxing ring. Now, if you're a bodybuilder, you're probably doing a 3-day-a-week split or doing 2 rounds of a 3-day-a-week split in 7 or 8 days. So anyway, you bodybuilders, this is a great chance for you to mix up your routine also. Almost every gym, no matter how crowded, has an area for suspension trainers. So what I want you to do, we're gonna camp out in this, you're gonna carve out a little niche in the gym, and that's gonna be yours. Now I know a lot of you are gonna say, it's rude to hog an area. Well, look around the gym in January. You're gonna see every machine occupied by someone sitting and texting. Oh, they're resting at 5 minutes between sets. So it's completely okay for you to just occupy one small area in the suspension trainer area, working out with 100% duty cycle, no rest at all. So here's the workout I want you to do. So you bring your own suspension trainer, you hang it, and you're going to do a low row for lats. You're going to bring over a set of dumbbells, and this needs to be a compromise. You want a set of dumbbells that you can do a dumbbell press for chest, but you're also going to do it for lunges. So you may have to compromise and have it a little too hard for chest and a little too easy for legs, or vice versa. So what you're going to do, you're just gonna do round robin with, you're not even gonna move. So you're gonna do a low row from the TRX, you're gonna do dumbbell press, you're gonna do your lunges, all in that same area. You can do crunches too, you can do planks, you can throw it in, but you're just going to do a round robin. So this is a high rep, low weight kind of workout. Again, it's a great way to let your joints rest and keep from getting frustrated in a crowded gym. That's it for today, my workout strategies for crowded gyms in January. Thanks for watching. Have feeders, Zane.